Welcome back to Singing Our Faith. As we've been working through the Presbyterian hymnal in this time when we can't sing together in large gatherings, we're exploring how the hymnal's organized and how the first third of Glory to God tells the story of God's salvation history. In today's episode, we'll be singing the final songs in the section Creation and Providence. These texts focus our praise on God, who is creator of all and remains intimately involved in all of creation, including our very lives. As we've discovered, singing about God's providence for all creation, the Psalms inspire many of the hymn texts we sing. Number 42, Your Faithfulness, O Lord, is Sure, is a paraphrase of Psalm 145. As we sing verses 1, 2, and 4, you'll find yourself both cared for by God as a part of the whole creation, and then invited to join your voice with all creation in praise. Number 43, popularly known as On Eagle's Wings, is another paraphrase of a psalm. Psalm 91 expresses God's providence as protecting us when we feel threatened or afraid. In response to each verse the soloist sings, we join in on the beloved refrain, which ends with the affirmation that God will hold you in the palm of his hand.
Make you to shine like the sun.
God who holds us in the palm of God's hand, as we sang in the previous song, is the God we know because God chooses to be in relationship with us. Like a mother who has borne us, highlights parental imagery of how God relates to us. As we sing verses 1 and 2, we sing of God like a mother and God like a father. The imagery for both verses comes from the wealth of Scripture speaking of God in such parental language. And the gentle tune reassures us of God's love and care for God's children. Psalms that have become beloved throughout the ages, Psalm 121 rises near the top. You might remember it begins, "I lift my eyes to the hills. From where will my help come?" The answer is an affirmation of God's providence. Our help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. Hymn number 45 is a paraphrase of Psalm 121. We'll sing the first two verses, and you may recognize a familiar Scottish tune named Dundee. One of the gifts of the Presbyterian and Reformed tradition to the broader church's congregational song historically was the metrical setting of psalms. The Scottish Psalter of 1561 is the source for Dundee, which is set to two texts in Glory to God. Is another paraphrase of a psalm. The text of "Unless the Lord the house shall build" is a paraphrase of Psalm 127. The psalm and the paraphrase invite a response of humility from us. We remember that God alone is the source of blessing for our lives and God's creation. Surprise, another psalm paraphrase. Psalm 128, which references walking in God's ways, the Lord's blessing God's people from Zion, and the final hope that Jerusalem's prosperity be seen, leads many to think this text may have been sung by ancient pilgrims as they made their way to Jerusalem. The focus of this paraphrase is that God is the source and giver of all blessings. They're not ours by right. The life of faith grows deeper as we take God's gift with thanks and with delight. Song in the section on creation and providence is a beautiful wedding of both themes, and it's inspired by the image of God's love being showered on God's people. The creation needs rain to grow and flourish, and this final song prays for God's love to rain down in our lives, that God's people may grow and flourish. Congratulations, friends, you've made it through the first two sections of Glory to God. As we tell the story of God's salvation history in the first third of the hymnal, we've sung about the triune God, and we've sung hymns and songs of creation and providence. Next week, the story continues as we begin God's covenant with Israel.